All right, welcome back to Dynasty Warriors Gundam 3. This is episode 17. And basically what we're doing here is we're working our way through the missions difficulty-wise, which is why you can see that I've got a bunch of things unlocked, but I haven't done them because I'm trying to do them in order as their difficulty setting suggests. Because we're still pretty early on in the game here, and you know we're still on our Troa Barton campaign. So in this mission, looks like we're fighting Kuru at the end of it.
And so, war is about to begin.
As far as important spots on the board, there are two catapults that are neutral at the start. And it's like enemy units are going to grab that one, and also one of the two communication stations. The communication facility, of course, if I take this, we'll bring in allied reinforcements as long as I've got the battle gauge to support it. And if I was to capture the enemy one, then obviously we could get rid of any of the units that are flagged as extra on there. And in this case, the enemy is being very aggressive as far as grabbing stuff. They've already grabbed both catapults. They've got an enemy unit probably using one of the catapults into one of the fields that we started with by the beginning of the game. And again, I'm just working my way through the Allied Communication Facility to get some help. You can see I'm already in kind of a desperation mode here.
Why am I having so much trouble?
Not really sure what kind of, or how powerful my suit is at this point, but you can definitely tell that I'm still just mainly relying on sort of the main melee combo. Although for heavy arms it's nice because when you get that move into the second and third motions of it, you know, you get those bullets that can kind of keep enemies off of you if they happen to be close by. Alright, so now we've managed to get the Allied Communication Center, and now we can turn our attention to probably Shiroko. Since he's right here in his big old suit.
Got what it takes.
So, things that are different in the
attention all pilots.
7 months that I haven't really made a recording. Okay, we also have Blackus making a neutral announcement.
You may have no idea what's right, but there's no point in giving up hope, right?
Unfortunately, her neutral announcement as turns both her and Kira into enemies of us in this stage. So
it
that's
like
nice. Thanks, Blackus.
Please provide backup.
Right now I'm going down to the Allied headquarters trying to clean things out. You can see the auto cannons killed shot down Emma, so I don't have to worry about that. We need to definitely build some cushion between our headquarters and where the enemy units can get to. So I'm going to go ahead and attempt to recapture this field here.
If I make it in time.
I'm disengaging! I can't keep fighting like this!
Just kind of... Okay, so I just lost Neil. But one of our allies did capture one of the catapults. So that'll be useful. The other field around our headquarters has fallen. And Shiroko is back where we are. So to do it him again. But when I started this series, like 3 years ago, and got like 10 episodes into it, and stopped for the first time, my experience with Gundam was a little bit more limited than it is now.
I need to learn from my past mistakes.
And over the last couple weeks,
how cares?
I've seen a lot more Gundam. I've actually seen Saw Shark counterattack all the way through. I just want to protect you. I may go into my feelings about that at some later point. But I also saw the compilation movies for the original Mobile Suit Gundam, which, you know, I appreciated. Probably talk about my thoughts on this series as a whole in a future video. But, you know, apparently Gundam Expo or something like that was supposed to happen. Didn't because there's a reason that nothing happened involving gathering too many people right at the moment.
How fascinating.
And so instead, the Gundam people released a lot of content online, including, again, the compilation movies for Mobile Suit Gundam, the compilation movies for Zeta, the new translation, the improved animation style. Depending on if you believe this, it's truly improved animation.
It looks like our points under attack.
Which, you know, I kind of appreciate the fact that came with that. Did that. There are some things in the new translation that I don't appreciate, and I just get the feeling, a feeling I didn't really get with the Mobile Suit Gundam compilation movie. That there's a lot of the story you just don't see in the Zeta Gundam compilation movie. But again, we'll talk about, we'll try to give that its own full episode. Finally saw all 7 parts of Gundam Unicorn. And also saw War in the Pocket. And I enjoyed both Unicorn and War in the Pocket for different reasons.
I'm disengaging. I can't
but
keep fighting like this.
It's funny that they both those series kind of reveal that Gundam has a
kind of
continuity problem.
Best way to end this battle? Cut off their escape route. And
you know, it's really, if they're going to keep doing UC stories, they kind of need to address that. And most of that continuity problem has to do with the identity and public awareness of new types.
Don't lower your guard until the last one has fallen.
But again, that's kind of worth its own full thing in exploring. So I'm not gonna do it right here, or right here, right now. So there were other things that they uploaded. They uploaded, I think, the Gundam 00 movie. Spirit of Trailblazers. I didn't really get into that, mainly because my connection to Gundam is mostly through UC, and even though the most important Gundam show as far as getting into Gundam for me, as for a lot of Americans, in the late 90s, very earliest 2000s. I think that Cartoon Network only started showing Gundam Wing on their Toonami block in 2000, even though the show came out in Japan in 1995. So Gundam Wing still remains my sort of outside UC experience when it comes to Gundam. Otherwise, it's just the levels and stuff that I've fought and played in Gundam Reborn. In regards to the Seed and Seed Destiny storylines, which, you know, so I don't really have much familiarity with them. And having watched the compilation movies of Mobile Suit Gundam and Mobile Suit Zeta Gundam, you become aware of just how much the levels that are based off of those don't really have much to do with the actual storylines. You know, because it's a game, because they need you to do several things on a level to get the most out of it, you end up doing things that never happen in the movie. I think that's particularly clear in the Char's counterattack levels, where Amuro's in the Rijizi for maybe the first 10 minutes of the movie and barely does anything other than running into Gunai for the first time and, of course, introducing Char new mobile suit, Sabi. But in Dynasty Warriors Gundam, you have a full level devoted to Amuro being in that suit, and you do all kinds of, you do a number of things that obviously didn't happen on the screen.
If you continue to resist, I can't promise you safety.
So,
mistakes on the battlefield.
There's kind of that going on. Got funnel issues.
Let's end things here and now.
But that, there's kind of that going on. So it was people like funnels. Alright, you can tell I'm really paying attention to what's going on the screen.
As a human with emotions, will I really be able to grind down?
Alright, so I'm trying to build up my, I'm A, trying not to get destroyed, although I think I have enough battle gauge to come back once if I were to get destroyed. I'm essentially trying to build up my special gauge in order to have something
cyber
to
new type
kill Koto with. And if you notice, I'm trying to combo attack things that aren't necessarily always enemy units. Again, that's because it's just very easy to kind of confuse the base units of the game with each other. A problem that's more acute when levels have certain restrictions as to what units can be there. Like, there's a level where everybody has round mobile suits, which means that it's likely that enemy units are going to be balls, and friendly units are also going to be balls. Alright, just trying to stay away from getting hit by that super attack. But if you can get in, one of the things is if you can get a combo going, they're kind of stuck in that, particularly at the difficulty level that we're at right now. So it is to your advantage to make sure that if you engage an enemy like this, that you get, you know, that you lead the attack and you keep with it.
I can't believe that went so poorly.
And that's what, that's what we did at the end here, was just to make sure that even though the first part of our combo string didn't hit anything because it was really too far away, once we were in that offensive string, it was less likely she was going to be able to break through it or just kind of shrug us off and attack us while we were busily doing that. Alright, so now we've reached level 22. We've unlocked a rank 2 heavy arm suit today, which we are keeping. I think we're keeping most of these. Again, it's so early in the game, you get 4 slots per suit type. And we completed the level for having captured 20 fields, which you can imagine. You reached that milestone pretty easy. Alright, and now we're going to go into the 3-star battle exercise under the tutorial. Now you can see we're in space here. The repair module is on the field. It's neutral, but it's also blocked off by barricades. So we can't get to those places. So we're going to have to fight around it and just kind of take the fields that are there until it opens up, and then we need to snag it as quick as we can. There's not a huge need for catapults in a level this small, so we're going to go grab the catapult field first. But
what are you grumbling about?
I'm not interested.
Mostly I'm trying to run around and grab territory. They've used their catapult to send units into like the one field that we controlled outside of our base.
This is the age of strategy.
I've run into some enemy units that came over from the enemy catapult field, but again,
like they said,
I got to the field fast enough that I didn't have to fight anybody.
Not a bad move.
So now we're gonna get rid of these gems. Okay, there are two characters. Oh, okay, the Black Tri-Stars are on the field, and
you
want to defeat them, but unfortunately, unlike some of the other side quests, we have to defeat them all. Now, they'll usually group together, but they'll group together in some way. In this case, there are two of them that are here with us, and then one of them somewhere else. But that's where it gets a little bit annoying. For sure, we're getting locked into real-time events.
These guys are powerful.
All right. Evidently, we captured a field and then lost a field, and then I'm not exactly sure what's going on, but we're getting our butts kicked by these two guys teaming up together. So we got a desperation attack here. Okay. Yeah, they're linked. Now, if you were linked to somebody else, it would give your, it would allow you to heal a little bit, and it would power up your special attack. I don't know if they get those values as AI players, but I would be surprised. Yeah, we blew up. Alright, so we got overwhelmed. There were just too many enemies, because I think there was the two members of the Black Tri-Stars, and Katagina was over there, and you'll notice the barricades get open, so we need to go and rush and get
I must return to the fight.
I will fight you.
Give it up.
The middle field.
Not bad at all.
Of course, the reason we're not doing that right now is because we're kind of stuck in this spot, or fighting these bosses. You can see our battle gauge has been, well, probably for normal reasons, but we failed to destroy the Black Tri-Stars in time, so
the attack on the enemy stronghold has begun.
That probably will have some negative consequence, but it does mean that they leave. As you can see, we're only fighting against Katagina right at the moment.
The world is worth protecting!
We avoided much of our special attack simply because she was on the ground. Now she's got friends.
Let's finish this operation.
I think we have friends too.
I don't like the looks of this.
Looks like one of our allies grabbed control of the middle field. So that's good. Alright, sorry. The video feed crapped out for a minute, so we'll jump you about just a couple seconds ahead. We're still, unfortunately, fighting Kira and Katagina in this area here, but we are about to take the field. So that's at least when the field starts operating, even though we've lost Dozel or Dunkel somewhere else on the battle field. So as soon as Catapult B starts stop flashing to ready, that means it'll start producing units of our own type. So that'll at least give us some distractions for trying to fight Katagina and now Kira. Alright, so we got one. Looking around. I know the other guy's here somewhere. There he is. Oh, okay, Glimmy showed up. I don't know.
I forgot. You're here to protect something important.
This shouldn't take long with you here. Let's do this.
Alright, I didn't realize that Glimmy was necessarily on our team. Okay.
It's in Formal Asame. Ready for launch.
Oh no.
Alright.
My armor.
So you can see here that the game has randomly generated four Mirasame as the boss of this stage, which we would have noticed at the beginning. We also could have looked to see who was making comments that we weren't fighting. But four Mirasame, of course, from Zeta Gundam and ordinarily the pilot of the Psycho Gundam. But the Psycho Gundam's not a boss.
All I know is fighting.
I mean, there are levels that bring in big units, but those big units are not themselves the boss of that stage. So, Four is assigned a different unit that would make some sense. In this case, the Titans Mark II.
This isn't going well. We need to retreat!
And I'm also now in the enemy headquarters. Alright, we're getting bombarded by the Tooth of Fire because that's what the Mark II does. She has activated it again.
As a human with emotions.
And we are almost dead. Now, to be fair, this will be like the second time we've blown up. I think what I'm, and my hope here, the reason I unloaded my special attack there, was the idea that it would give me just enough to take the field. So then, of course, throw handfuls of squishies
I'll annihilate everything.
At the enemy. Alright, well now I'm just trying to keep her off. There we go. She's still coming, though. Got a couple of good shots there. Again, trying to make sure that we're in the attack string when she's around so that, we get the sort of the raking fire with heavy arms and gun. And also so that, we're not stuck being one getting hit if she shows up. Now we're kind of juggling her with Glimmy a little bit. Now Glimmy should be healing us a little bit here. And this will allow us to do our big super attack where we just sort of rain missile fire. I don't like it as much.
You can't think things over and try again if you die, you know?
The best life to me is a life that is based on emotions.
All systems still go. I'm okay. Gotcha. That's it.
All right, so now we're hopefully getting close. A little bit of a charge in strike with some of the front missile pods.
All I know is fight. Yeah. I'm not sure I'm the right man for the job yet.
Gotcha.
Alright, now she's blocking pretty good here.
He got away.
We finally broke through that. Again.
I believe in you. I felt a light emanating from your soul.
So, it's just the way that works. And, we can move on to the next mission. And we've picked up another heavy arm suit. This one's got three upgrade slots at rank 2. Again, there's no reason not to just pick